I was playing that game last time. It's a game. I love it. Madden 24. Madden 24. It's so good. I wanted to try it out.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis.
Let's do rookie. You know, you gotta start off good, and you gotta change it, bro. You know, gotta keep your weight up. Lowest to highest, great. They did it to me. CD. Oh, okay.
To get us started now, the kicker Chris Boswell, and we are underway from AT&T Stadium. Fielded just outside the goal line.
Oh, that was a good return, though.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here, right at the 30-yard line. So here the Cowboys now ready to go on offense for the first time. And they'll be led out by the rookie six-rounder out of Stanford, Tanner McKee.
For every rookie prospect, there are always nerves involved in this moment. Running your team out to start a game. But there's a reason they brought him in the room to make him their starter today. They believe he can overcome those nerves and lead his team to a victory. He's up to it at the collegiate level and really make himself into a leader and someone you can envision doing the exact same thing here in the NFL.
Oof.
Now the throw here complete on the right sideline. It'll go down as a gain of six, and that's going to bring up second down.
I think we caught that, right? I definitely thought that was going to be incomplete. I don't know how he caught that. He went.
McKee now.
I'm just thought someone.
Throw left sideline falls incomplete.
Well, that's a defensive coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
Well, McKee will look to throw it.
Bam.
Pass taken in. That is the tight end. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle is made here at the Cardinals 21.
I'm going to run it. Oopsies.
Back to throw. McKee. Pass to the tight end, Riley.
I didn't mean to do that. I didn't mean to do that.
Josh Riley from 21 yards away. And the Cowboys get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. So they get this tight end away from the line to the outside, and he works his way in for six.
Tight ends are not just...
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And this is caught at the five. And this play is not going to work. He's out of bounds, well shy of the goal line. And the try for two, unsuccessful. I'm going to go out on a limb and say that you don't like that call on the opening drive of the game.
It's a very strong limb that you're out on right now. Okay, look. The game between college and the NFL continues to creep closer. But that is truly a college play, not an NFL play. Because you'd snap the ball from the 3-yard line there, whether it's going for one or going for two. So it makes sense to try it that way to maybe fake it. In this case, from the 15, makes zero sense.
And now your lead's just 6-0 instead of 7-0.
No, wait, let's do 50. Let's just do 50.
On the ground is Jacobs to start the drive. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
I don't think we're going to use it, but I'm going to try it. Back.
To pass. Here's Jordan Love.
I got him. Incomplete.
Third quarter. It's incomplete. Charles already trailed by touchdown early. This offense
don't make him get the first. Don't make him get the first, guys.
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense.
Dang it.
But I think even more so, he's going to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
I don't even know. J-Love's not the quarterback.
First down, Love to pass.
Incomplete.
It's incomplete.
That's only appeared to be a play call. They were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was all a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Oh, you got it. I got him. Oh, come on. Don't get that first.
And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. We know they have these RPOs in their playbook, and look, we're seeing it here in the first quarter.
With 30 seconds left?
I think we're going to see it as the game continues.
They trotted him out early for a reason, partner. Oh, they're letting them know that this is in the arsenal.
Why did you let him catch that?
You better be prepared, because this is going to be an all-day affair trying to stop them.
And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 22-yard line. Jordan Love, ready on first down here.
Why would you leave him wide?
He finds his target, it's Schultz. And he will be out of bounds here on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. 6-0 our score after one.
6-0, I guess.
Cardinal football here to start quarter number two. In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. Back to the running game with Jacobs. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal.
They're going to get a touchdown. It's obvious.
Love.
What was that?
And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. He released that awkwardly. It almost looked like a pitcher who gripped his fastball a little too hard and let it go late, and it bounced in front of the plate.
Yeah, one of those fastballs that ends up at 57 feet, not 60 feet, 6 inches.
Nice catch.
Just a little short with the arm, which is unusual because we saw him in warm-ups. He's got a big, strong arm when he delivers it with confidence.
5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal.
Bam. I saw him. You need to be like, oh, almost on sides.
Working out of the gun.
Oh, why? I like it.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona.
Oh, I bet.
Jordan Love taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Cardinals are an extra point away now from moving out in front. Extra point put through by Boswell. And they take
seven
the lead here at 7-6.
We need to get this
Boswell
comeback.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And he returns this to the 22. Well, before we get to our next drive,
the big
one is coming. No, not the Super Bowl, but the $1 million Madden Bowl, the crown jewel of the Madden Championship Series. My friend Archie says you're not going to want to miss this one. It streams live January 30th, 31st, up through the final on February 1. Tune into the EA Madden NFL Twitch channel, 6:30 Eastern, 3:30 on the West Coast, as we find out who is this year's best of the best.
Got you.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. He's going to fire one deep on the middle. It's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Well, that's my team, so.
Some coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there's not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
Loss here as he's taken down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. On third down, they're going to go with the option. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. And how about this, a fake?
I love you.
And this is caught. Nice little juke. Gets through and now an opening. There are times to run that fake and there are times to not run it. And this without question would fall in the latter category.
Well, I don't know about without question, partner. I think we should look at the analytics on this one because, the analytics say, without question.
Dang.
You should have gone ahead and punted the football because now not only did you not get it and you really have no chance to, what a short field that you turned the ball over to the other offense.
Pick.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
A second down throw for Love. That'll be caught by Parker. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. It's a search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Here's Love. Look in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. And the ball comes out. Love lost it, and this ball recovers on the offense. But remember, they cannot advance it here in the final 2 minutes of the half, so this will be blown dead, and it'll come back to the spot of the fumble.
Trying to throw on second down,
but this one is incomplete.
That was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
What kind of throw is that?
It's
seconds left. It's seconds left.
Nice call by the defense there on third down. Just from the field with extra defensive backs in their dime package. Nowhere to go with the football. Forces the incompletion.
Exactly.
The 20-yard line. And just like that, on we head to half number two.
And
we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Cards with the lead, and they will get this football first as the second half gets started. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. Starting the third quarter with Cook. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six. Ball on the 28-yard line. Here's the second down at six.
Zigzags.
Throwing. Love.
Nope.
To the right side, he's got Parker. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. Love from the gun. They'll get this one to Cobb complete. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Up the middle, it's Cook. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Let's see. Where do you got this kid?
Now a second down throw for Love here. And he couldn't get that one to his man. Short of it, it's low and incomplete. Right now, the story of this game continuing to be the defenses because the offenses are finding it difficult to establish any rhythm whatsoever.
I like how you come to us in praise of defense, Brandon, because that's exactly right. That was an incompletion for us there, but we've seen it throughout this game. Both of these defense coordinators, they're a step ahead of their offensive counterparts.
Here's Johnny Hester now.
This is our comeback.
For the second time.
Every time
they no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive.
Why is everyone doing it?
And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football. Yeah, he's taken down. Following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on second and 13.
Donalds.
On the give, this is Nichols.
Oh, that was all me. That sucked.
And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line.
That's a big loss of three,
and it brings up third down.
I just got this.
Now an inside draw. This is their fullback.
That's why I stopped.
To the 26. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down. Out now comes the Cowboys punter. On presumably to punt, though he did complete a pass earlier.
Come on.
And look at this, another fake. Escapes the defender. He can't tackle.
Come on, please.
A curious decision to go for it, but it pays
off.
Let's go. First down.
Boom, bro.
So a moment to catch our collective breath after 50. The fourth down conversion.
Sorry, guys, let you down.
Back now in Arlington.
Fine, really.
And we've got a Danny here. One-point game as we begin the fourth.
That touchdown.
McKee now to
throw. Oh,
he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
Just because you got the lead in the fourth, it doesn't mean you have to play it safe. I like the aggressive play call there to push it downfield. That time, it didn't work out.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And running with power.
It's a miracle. Good job.
It's going to be pushed out of bounds inside the 10-yard line. A big play now for catch and run. And even 50 yards. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll get this down inside the 5 and 4 before he's out of bounds. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of 5.
Oh, that was good.
He is going nowhere in a hurry as he is going to lose yardage here in a big way.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Ankle breaking. What the heck is that? Oh, fourth and goal, really? All you want to do is to be pass.
Oh, it's right there. Here we go. It's Jake Moody now in a big spot. Fourth quarter, 2 minutes on the clock, and a tight one-point game. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And they've got a fourth down now in a game that, to be honest, has been pretty much everything we could have asked for. Now the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it.
Oh, what did they do? No.
They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. And as a result, they could have had the lead with a field goal. Instead, they turn the ball over on downs. This late in the fourth quarter, a field goal would have given them the lead. Why would they fake it there?
Seems like a really big gamble. Maybe a gamble that'll cost them a game because I'm one that takes the points in that spot. Go ahead, kick the field goal, take the lead, and think that you can win the game.
We got to have two hands on the football here as they run the first down. And this is going to double their room to maneuver. Able to get it from the 5 to the 10 yard.
It's fourth quarter. 1 minute
in. A tight game like this. Such a tough spot for the offense to be in. Even though they have the lead, Charles, back up so close to their goal line. They got to protect the football.
And that's when you have to take care of your team with play calling as well. Not a lot of misdirection, not a lot of counters, not a lot of plays where you have extra ball handling. Get it right to the hands of your running back. Tell them to take care of the ball and try to move forward.
I didn't even get to go there.
5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down. He was close to falling on that sideline, but able to stay in bounds like you know his coach wants him to do and keep that clock moving.
Isn't it funny that we're watching this play when we had that discussion just yesterday about this? What do you do in this scenario? What do you, you know, what's your mindset? It appeared to me that he'd totally forgotten that he needed to stay in bounds, and then the last says, oh no, I better get down. And he ended up doing the right thing. But at that point, maybe close to letting it slip away.
Well, obviously, Charles, this was by no means an offensive track meet. I mean, the defenses were destroying this ball game, but hey, they got enough points to get the job done. And at the end of the day, that's all that matters.
You're absolutely right about that, partner. In such a low-scoring game, it completely changes everything you had planned to do out there. Fortunately for them, they got just enough scoring to bring home the win. And in this type of a game, the play of their defense, that became one of their biggest keys.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at EASports.com.
See you later. Bye.